What up, though, everybody? Welcome back to Daily Upside, the sports card show where we talk about sports cards every day. Today's episode is going to be super dope, but before we get into it, I want to remind everybody about the giveaway we're doing this month. The end of the month is coming soon. This month flew by. I'm giving away a box of Panini Black. All you have to do to be eligible is sign up for the newsletter. You'll be able to find more information on my Instagram. So before you listen to this episode, pause it, head over there, enter the contest. It's super, super easy. And you can get a free box of cards. I mean, this box of cards is going for like $500. You got a chance to get some rookie auto patches, Ja Morant, Zion Williamson, big, big plays, Kobe White. So definitely head over there, shoot your boy a follow, follow the rules. Again, they're very, very simple. By the time you're listening to this podcast, everything will be up and ready to go. Now let's get into the show. I checked out some NBA news today, but didn't see much. So we're just going to get right into sports cards. Yesterday, a couple of cool auctions ended. We saw this Luka Doncic Court Kings end for $789.77. That is a new all-time high for this card, especially BGS 9.5. I believe this is the level 3. So for those of you who don't know about Court Kings, it's kind of similar to Select in a way. There's just different levels. If we scroll up here, I believe like this is the tier 1. And then, this is the tier 3. I don't know what the tier 2 and tier 4 look like. Tier 4 is super rare. That's going to be like your courtside rookie. So, yeah, hit a new high yesterday. And I think this is just kind of a testament to what we were talking about yesterday, about how paper cards are going to have, you know, some type of surge. I know it's going to happen. The thing we need to figure out is which one it's going to be. And it's not just going to be one. It's going to be a couple. Court Kings is definitely looking like one of them. The benefits about Court Kings is that it's a set that, you know, kind of goes back to the Giannis days. So when you buy these sets, you want to make sure that the modern stars all have them. So, for example, I really like Donruss, but like Giannis doesn't have a Donruss. I really like Revolution, but Giannis doesn't have a Revolution. Giannis does have a Court Kings, and Giannis does have a Panini rookie, which is why you guys see me kind of high on Chronicles Panini sometimes. But yeah, this card ended for a pretty decent amount, and I think it's just going to keep going up, as well as some of the other base cards. I was looking at some of them, and you know, the Hoops ended yesterday for 340, which is a pretty low for that card. Hoops could definitely be a play. I'm not too much of a fan of them. I know I talked about Giannis's Hoops yesterday, but again, Giannis is just from a different era, so it's different for him. But you know, I do think this is pretty cheap considering Giannis's Hoops is going to be a play. So even though I'm not a fan of the card or the card stock, I do think in terms of its price point, it's a pretty good value. I wouldn't be surprised if these were hitting about $500 once Luka kind of gets into MVP form. I remember last season they were neck and neck with the Donruss. The Donruss actually might have been a little bit lower than the Hoops, and now we've kind of seen that reversed. But you know, could be an opportunity here to get some gains as these are trending for lower than normal. Another one that ended was his Revolution. That one sold for $575. This is my favorite out of the group just because it's just an aesthetically pleasing card. Has a lot of shimmer shine. It has the galactic, it has the parallels to chase. You know, when you start looking at like Hoops and stuff, it's really confusing. Like Hoops yellow, Hoops, you know, it's just not a great looking set. And, you know, I think Revolution is definitely, you know, something that people might want to look into. You know, Lucas is pretty high, but a lot of the other guys are undervalued, you know, Jason Tatum, Trae Young. So yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what paper card plays out. But, you know, I think over the next few weeks, we'll all kind of sit, you know, see them hit new highs. I was looking at the Hoops of Luka, and you know, this is where I, you know, kind of mentioned that it was really high at one point. It was hitting like $600. You know, it was kind of trending with Giannis. Now it's just way down here. So we haven't seen these prices in quite some times. In fact, if we look at the 3 month, they're down 40%, which is odd considering most Luka cards are only down like 13 or 14%. If you look at his Prizm for the last 3 months, what is it? Yeah, down 13%. So That's a big downfall. So, you know, again, don't like the Hoops in terms of how it looks, but in terms of just overall value, it could be a play. Nothing confirmed yet. Haven't done enough research. Just kind of, you know, finding this out as I'm talking to you guys. But, you know, that's something to look at there. You know, if this was a stock or if this was a crypto or something like that, you know, we wouldn't have like one card, you know, way up and then the other just kind of way down. So, yeah, not making a lot of sense. Even the one month average is up 16%. So they're trending. So yeah, we'll kind of see how that plays out and keep an eye on that. Could be an opportunity to get some of this percentage back. I think the way it works for me is I kind of look at Prizm and I see what Prizm's doing. And if Prizm is doing well, which we see it is over the last month, you know, eventually all the other college cards will follow suit. Once this kind of hits, you know, all time high or gets back to that that high price point, you know, people that start going to get the other values, and the game is to get them before they do. So right now, nobody's buying hoops. Nobody's buying the base cards. So maybe we want to grab those before they win. They even grab them. Let's look at the Revolution and see if it's kind of the same thing. I bet the Revolution at one point was really up, and it's probably similar to the hoops where it's just down like 30%. Yep. So down 26%. So we haven't really seen these paper cards catch up yet to the Prizm. The Prizm's down 13%. It's probably going to catch up, you know, as the season gets a little bit closer. And, it, you know, it's just a matter of time before these get back into the $800 range or anything of that nature. So, yeah, speaking of the Prizm rookie cards, you know, I posted this yesterday, and this is kind of what I wanted to talk about today. And I asked you guys, are you taking 5 Prizm rookies? Or are you taking 1 Prizm silver? And I posted this to my Instagram, and I also posted it to my Instagram story. And I was kind of shocked by the answer. Before I get into this, for some of you guys, I just want to let you know, there is no right or wrong answer for this. It's basically, it's just based on, you know, perspective and how you want to invest. But there are some things that I want to point out here. So 61% of you guys said you'd rather have the Prizm silver. And I get that, you know, as an investor, as a collector, you know, we want the better card. We want the shinier card. But is it the best investment is the question. So this is going to be a little bit confusing to do, you know, over a podcast within my head. But if you look at Luka over the last year, you can see his Prizm PSA 10s was at $83 at his low point. And his Prizm Silver PSA 10 was at $550. And I don't know how accurate that is, because I picked up some pretty cheap cards. But I guess this is over the last year. If we do over the last 2 years, yeah, we get to those cheaper values. Man, can you believe this card was $27? So yeah, if you do the math on this, and for simple math, I know I asked about 5 cards, but we'll just do 10 cards for simple math. If you would have bought 10 Prizm PSA 10 Trae Young cards, that would have costed you $830. And that would have got you 10 cards. So let's make it simpler. Let's just say you spent $1,000. If you would have spent $1,000 on Trae Young Prizm PSA 10s, you would have got about 11 PSA 10, you know, Trae Young cards. And if you would have took that same $1,000 and spent it on a PSA 10 silver, you would have got 2 PSA 10 silvers. So if we do the math today, if we were to hold those cards and sell them today, if we had 11 Prizm PSA 10 cards and they're going for $670 a piece right now, we'd be at $7,370, which would be a pretty insane profit, like really, really insane. And if you do the math on the Prizm Silver, you know, you would have had 2 of those cards and they're going for about $3,000 right now. Well, you would have only had $6,000. So buying the Prizm PSA 10 would have netted you a $1,000 profit. Even if we look at this chart on Card Ladder, we can see that over the last year, the Prizm PSA 10 has went up 700%, while the Prizm PSA 10 Silver only went up 400%. So, you know, if we would have bought these cards, you know, in their infancy, then it would have been obviously a better investment to buy the Prizm PSA 10. It wouldn't have been as sexy or as a shiny, and it probably wouldn't have been as believable. Like if I would have told you that this card was going to hit $670 when you were buying it at $80, you probably would have looked at me and called me an idiot. So of course, most of us didn't do that. Now, if we look at the 3-month chart, just to kind of make it a little, actually, let's look at the 1-month chart. If we look at the 1-month chart, we'll probably get the same thing. If we would have bought 10 Prizm PSA 10 of Trae Young, you know, that would have costed us $4,290. We would have took that same $4,290 and bought some of his Prizm Silver. At their lowest, within the last month, they were $1,825. That would have got us 2 Prizm PSA 10s. So we look at the price point today. We got 10 Prizm PSA 10s. They're going for $670 right now. That's going to net us $6,700 if we were to sell today. Take those same 2 Prizm PSA 10s that are going for, you know, $3,000, and we'd be at $6,000, and we'd have a little change left over because, you know, the Prizms didn't cost that much. So with that, we're looking like we're kind of breaking even on those two trades. You know, both of those are both up. In fact, if we look at the percentage gained on Card Ladder again, we'll see the Prizm PSA 10 Silver is at 59% and the Prizm is at 56% in terms of percentage gained. And, you know, if we go to Luka, we can see the same thing. Those percentages are pretty much the same. So what we're seeing here is that long term, it was obviously a better play to buy the Prizm PSA 10. And that short term, it's looking like it's the same exact play. And I think that's really, really interesting, because that means a lot. You know, that's going to be really beneficial for the guy who can't afford the Prizm PSA 10. Who can't afford the Prizm PSA 10 Silver. Everyone doesn't have $8,200 to invest in a Luka Prizm PSA 10. Everyone doesn't have $3,000 to invest in a Trae Young Prizm PSA 10. But what this chart is showing us is that whether you buy the Prizm PSA 10 or the Prizm, your gain is still going to be the same. So you can still get into the game and make the same amount of money based on, you know, your investment. So I think that's super important. It's also showing us that if you're a guy who does have the money, buying the Prizm PSA 10 base still might be a better play, because now you have some leverage in terms of when you want to get in and you want to get out. Let's say you buy 10 Prizm PSA 10s. Let's say they go up 30%. Well, now you can sell four of those and keep six, or maybe you can sell six and then the rest is all profit. You can't do that with the Prizm PSA 10 silver. It's one card, you know, it's one share. You can't break it into fractions. With the base card, you can fraction it off, and that can be really beneficial. There's also the idea of, like, because it's one card, well, maybe you're not going to get scammed on, you know, at such a high level. Maybe it can't get lost in the mail, you know, if there's 10 of them. So you can kind of, you know, play it a little more safe. You know, there's some risk sending out an $8,000 card, and maybe that risk doesn't feel as bad if you send out a $1,000 card. You know, maybe if you lose that $1,000, it sucks, but it's not $8,000. So there's definitely some benefits to buying the base cards. And again, it's not as sexy. Long term, it might be risky. You know, some of these cards have super high pop reports. Are they going to be able to keep up these volumes compared to the silver? You know, we don't know. But from the data we're looking at, there's definitely some benefits in buying the base. It allows you to not have all your eggs in one basket, and it allows you to exit your position within fractions. So again, no right or wrong answer. Both of these cards are moving up at the same price, but I was really shocked to see that 61% of you went with the Prizm Silver PSA 10, especially considering how expensive it is, you know? So a lot of us can't afford that, at least not the risk. So yeah, thought I would make this podcast for those of you who don't have $8,200, but maybe you have $2,000 and you feel like buying a base card is dumb. It's not, based on the data. They're actually moving around the same rate. I actually wrote a blog post about this a little while back, September 2019, and I put Prizm Base, a safer investment than Prizm Silver. And that's kind of the catalyst behind this. I'm not saying it's a better investment. I'm just saying it might be a safer investment, at least for the short term. And I talk about some of the high risk reward of the Prizm Silver PSA 10. I talk about how it's cheaper to keep her. You know, if you buy a Prizm base card for $150, you may not be such in a hurry to get your money back. You know, you might just be like, hey, I paid $150 for it, I'll hold on to it. However, if you pay $2,000 for a card, you might be like, hey, if it hits $3,000, I'm done, I'm getting out. So, you know, you can read about this. It's definitely interesting stuff here. Gary Vee retweeted it. He thought it was pretty interesting as well. I like to think that I'm the reason that Gary Vee's buying base cards instead of silver cards. I don't know if you guys noticed that, but he's buying a lot of base cards. So, you know, he shouted this out for me. And this was actually how a lot of you started to follow me, was because Gary Vee tweeted out this article. So I'll leave the link to this in the description. Obviously, some of the price points are, you know, a little dated considering this came out, you know, last year. But, you know, the fundamentals are still the same. So, yeah, let me know what you guys think about this. Outside of that, that's pretty much it for today's show, guys. It's a little slow motion until the season starts. I'll get into some more plays pretty soon. We still got the pick of the week that just came out, and we're dropping another one tomorrow. So if you haven't subscribed to the newsletter, definitely do so to get that. The Sports Cards pick of the week is only for the premium members, so that'll be coming out tomorrow evening. So I definitely want you guys there to receive that. So sign up for the newsletter. Don't forget about the giveaway that we're doing, and check me out on Twitter, guys. Leave a like, subscribe, all that good stuff. Share the show with your friend. That's it for me. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Happy investing.